Some of the posts on Twitter have photos along with them. We want to cache those too. At the moment, we're only caching resources at install time, whereas the photos appear over the lifetime of the app with the posts. So we want to cache photos as they appear. We could put these photos in IDB along with the rest of the post data, but that means we'd need to read the pixel data and convert it into a blob, and that's kind of complicated, and it also loses streaming, which has a performance impact. When we get an item from a database, we have to take the whole thing out in one lump, then convert it into image data, then add it to the page. Whereas if we get the image from a cache, it will stream the data, so we don't need to wait for the whole thing before we display anything. This is more memory efficient and leads to faster renders, even if the data is coming from the disk. For that reason, the cache API is a much better fit. But since we're into the advanced stages of the course, I haven't made this totally straightforward. Here's the code for the image. It's a responsive image. Because images can appear at a variety of different widths, this responsive image lets the browser decide which image to load based on the width of the window and also the network conditions. So when the post data arrives through the WebSocket, which version do we cache? Well, we wait until the browser makes the request. Then we hear about it in the service worker. We go to the network for the image, and once we get a response, we put it in the cache. But at the same time, we send it onto the page. Note that we put the image into a separate cache to the rest of the static content. We reset the content of our static cache whenever we update our JavaScript or our CSS, but we want these photos to live between versions of our app. Next time we get a request for an image that we already have cached, we simply return it. But here's the trick. We'll return the image from the cache even if the browser requests a different size of the same image. Posts on Twitter are short-lived, so if the browser requests a bigger version of the same image, returning a smaller one from the cache isn't really a problem. Returning a bigger image than the one the browser asked for, that's perfectly fine too. We're not wasting bandwidth by doing that. In fact, getting a smaller version of something we already have cached, that would be a waste of bandwidth. Also this, resizing windows back and forth, it's only really something web developers do. We've covered most of the APIs you need to be able to cache images. There's only one thing left to cover. You can only use the body of a response once. As in, if you read the response as JSON, you cannot then read it as a blob. This is because the original data has gone. Keeping it in memory would be a waste. Also, RespondWith uses the body of the response as well, so you cannot later read it again. In most cases, this is great, because if the response was like a 3 GB video going to a video element on the page, the browser doesn't need to keep the whole 3 GB in memory. It only needs to keep the bit it's currently playing, plus a little bit extra for buffering. However, this is a problem for our photos. We want to open a cache, fetch from the network, and send the response to both the cache and back to the browser. Using the body twice like this doesn't work, but we can fix this by cloning the response we send to the cache. So now a clone goes to the cache, and the original gets sent back to the page. The browser keeps enough of the original request around to satisfy all of the clones.